Sliver of a black line. And there's the rate of these drugs, two of these drugs. We really grow about 100,000-fold better with these non-physiological / unnaturally structured antibody fragments. Now, this is an interesting issue of specificity is of interest. One, because we cannot afford to knock out essential proteins in the brain by non-specific catalysts. And then this is a great puzzle as to how you get specificity with a catalyst. Turns out that our catalytic antibodies combine a sort of both parts of the enzyme and antibody world. This is by epitope analysis and by so we sequence the products. Here these are the bonds that are hydrolyzed. Here, the major bond is this histidine glutamine bond that's broken. These are minor clearances here. And here is the non-covalent recognition site. In other words, this little peptide here on the C terminus completely blocks catalysis, even though it is not itself a substrate. We call this the remote. It's a remote recognition. And the non-covalent binding is happening remotely. And then a subsite is the catalytic site in this the triangle and the circle here, they have to be hydrogen bonded in order to get activation of catalysis. Now this is not really a part of the non-covalent binding site. And yet, the catalysis is highly specific. We get hydrolysis of A-beta, we do not get hydrolysis of HIV-GB120, extracellular domain of EGFR, albumin, protein A, valbumin, and a host of other proteins. My collaborator, Einar Sigurdsson at New York University, he injected our single, the heterodimeric small catalytic antibody that we identified, he injected it into the brain. And then he did immunohistochemistry, and these dots here are A-beta tracks. Here is the needle track right here. That's the needle with which the antibody was injected. Here is the antibody injection, and this is PDS injection, as you can see. Around the needle, there is a lot of clearance of the amyloid tracks. And also in vitro, we can block aggregation and so forth, just like the IgMs I showed you. A lot of in vitro data are available indicating that we can block the aggregation phenomenon. And also, very quickly now, this is more technological than conceptual. And once we have improvements on that, we regrow this VL2. As an IgGF. It's an unnatural molecule, but it must mimic nature if we want long half-life. And this is simply showing catalysis by this unnatural IgGL, in which the heavy chain, the VH domain, has been replaced by the light chain. So there are two VL domains in this IgGL. And then it's, I will just mention, without explaining this picture a lot, I will say that these unnatural, non-physiological molecules that are shown you, they mimic the structure of primordial antibodies. The immune system really started 300 million years ago with sharks and another family of fish. So these structures that we have identified go back to the primordial, the structure is similar to these primordial antibodies. So the hypothesis that one would make is that catalysis was a primordial function for antibodies. And as the immune system evolved, that function was supplanted, was replaced by high affinity binding as an adaptive function. We don't care what your progeny and phylogeny, most progenies will not care. But if you really want high catalytic turnovers, this helps us understand how to engineer the best catalyst, and this is simply a repeat that we can we can, there's no evidence of inflammation or of deposition of the immune complexes of A beta in the blood vessels, in these injections that might inaugurate it in the brain. So I think it's reasonable to be optimistic that we can have highly efficacious clearance of A beta without causing side effects. And essentially, we have two candidate preparations. One is the polyclonal IgM, human IgMs, and the other is the engineered formulated antibodies that are not natural, but they are going to be safe because they don't really have new antidotes. And these are all human antibodies. Thank you for your attention.
One question?
Yes. I guess I'm a really nice talk, but I'm not sure what's actually being cleared. Are you clearing plaques? Are you clearing oligomers? Are you clearing both? Because if you're clearing plaques, it may have to be protected rather than damaging, which is what people are starting to say. Mm-hmm. Would you create more problems than if you didn't clear?
I agree with you, but I found a way to stay away from the controversy. That's because these antibodies recognize all forms of A-beta. What we saw in the immunohistochemistry chemistry is obviously only the plaques. But we've done in vitro studies where we've taken defined oligomers and monomers and larger fibrils. And all forms of the A-beta are hydrolyzed almost equivalently by this recombinant antibody that I described.
Okay, let's thank Dr. Paul. Thank you. Yes.
Right now, we're running a bit late. Luckily, there are only two talks after the break, but nevertheless, I'd like you all to be back here in 10 minutes. Please. Be back here by 10 past. Just check your head and come back. There's no problem.